What baking soda does is it reacts with acidic ingredients. A little bit of baking soda into some vinegar and it should bubble up in foam. And this is what's actually happening in the baking process when you're making your baked goods. These bubbles are released, the gases are released, and that gives you the lightness in your biscuit, for example. Now, baking powder is a little bit different. So baking powder, all you really need to do is to add baking powder in a recipe that has some moisture to it, because that moisture encourages a similar reaction like this, but it also reacts with heat. So it starts leavening when you mix your batter or your cookie dough together, and then it also works when you put it in the oven. What if you only have baking soda or you only have baking powder in your house and your recipe calls for the other? Well, say your recipe calls for 1 teaspoon of baking soda, you're going to need 3 times as much baking powder in that recipe. If your recipe calls for 1 teaspoon of baking powder and you only have baking soda, you'll need to use about 1/3 of a teaspoon of baking soda. And since you're missing in baking soda the acidic ingredient in the box, you need to add a little bit of acid to your recipe as well. So that would be about 1 teaspoon of lemon juice. You could use yogurt, you could use a little bit of buttermilk as well. You might get a slightly different taste when you substitute here, but you will in fact get that leavening that you need. So there you go, guys, moisture to it, because that moisture encourages a similar reaction like this, but it also reacts with heat. So it starts leavening when you mix your batter or your cookie dough together, and then it also works when you put as much baking powder in that recipe. If your recipe calls for 1 teaspoon of baking powder and you only have baking soda, you'll need to use about 1/3 of a teaspoon of baking soda. And since you're missing, what baking soda does is it reacts with acidic ingredients. A little bit of baking soda into some vinegar and it should bubble up in foam. And this is what's actually happening in the baking process when you're making your baked goods. These get in the oven. What if you only have baking soda or you only have baking powder in your house and your recipe calls for the other? Well, say your recipe calls for 1 teaspoon of baking soda, you're going to need 3 times. Bubbles are released, the gases are released, and that gives you the lightness in your biscuit, for example. Now, baking powder is a little bit different. So baking powder, all you really need to do is to add baking powder in a recipe that has some